That red light on.
Yeah, we Gucci. All right, we Gucci. All right, now. This is how we gonna do this shit, and I ain't about to get flagged, so. You know what I'm saying? We could. We could.
Been a couple years since a nigga got good. Say your boy, he down. It ain't much that you do that I can't do for me. I already got my team. I tell her we good, we good, we good, we good. We good.
You wasn't there when we needed your help, so we good, they wouldn't do it, I did it myself, now we good, sorry my nigga can't buy what you're selling, we good, sorry my nigga, I heard that my ex asking about me, just tell him we good, some juice inside of my cup and some OG inside of B-Wood. Blowing on hookah, some good girls is here, but I swear they not here to be good. That boy from Brooklyn, they want what he cooking, they heard that his recipe good. Horoscope say that we bad for each other, but the sex will be good. Get with the Scorpio, I'm getting more Fritos. They getting chips, but I'm getting Doritos. About to get more Cheetos. I get you wet, how you busting like torpedoes. You can't keep time, you trying to forfeit though. She said we good, nigga, you trying to kill me. I'm trying to make sure you good or you feel me.
Do you have a credit card to help you earn points to travel this summer?
I don't know the fuck going on. We still out here vibing, man. Shit, I'm just
about to play. What I've been through. We got London on the
train. I ain't gonna fake this.
They only know what I
tell. Since I promise I'll never stop going in, gotta be one of the best mixtapes of all time.
New chick that I just fought with some good hair, that's a brand new mouth. Down know about a brand new belt, we on a roll, let another motherfucker got a brand new clock. Down know about a brand new chopper for the same old head, a nigga mad, cause a nigga can't stop. Down know about the old school work that I keep put up, when I pull it out, they be like, who that? Down know about the old school days, when a nigga had ways, I swear, every night I walk through it. Down know about the old school day, Mac City, with Gemma, nigga want me, she some booty. Got an old school hoe trying to school me, so I'ma hit that pussy from the back, make a straight line. And it's still money over bitches. Rich homie over all niggas. I need some more karma than these digits. I gotta ran my sack up crazy. I might buy my dad a Mercedes. And I just find out I got a baby on the way. I know the situation sound a little crazy. And they ain't know I was worth that much till I dropped that mixtape and sold they had. And they ain't know I was on them purpose, but they know I be on them damn. And they know I ain't with that group of shit, but got mad love for my fans. I can't take every picture. You gotta understand, but they don't know. Yeah. What I've been through, yeah. They don't know the hell. They only know what I tell them. They don't know my timing, y'all. I pulled up, watch for the guy, they were tripping. I know about the bad that a nigga had stuffed in the trunk. They were too busy worried about the shit. I know about the homie that I got locked up, money all they had with. They don't know he going through it. They ain't know I'm a boss already. They ain't never 23. Now them niggas trying to have me how I do it. They don't know about the pain. Pain that a nigga been going through lately, baby. Shit done gotta look crazy lately. Shoot a nigga, make it as a gravy, baby. And that pussy so wet, I might recruit myself in the Navy, baby. Used to be Joe Washington, now Fred Frank. I had to change the face. I don't know about the new spot that I just got with them cameras everywhere, so they see your ass. I'm in New York, spending Eno cash. A broke nigga, I can never be your ass. And I'm the future nigga, I see your past. Who the fuck told you I wanna be your ass? With these diamonds looking like water, boy, I got Nemo, man. And I ain't know that my mama still working, they ain't know I'm inside, they ain't know I'm still hushing. They ain't know about the spot on Christmas. Them uncle me had two times, got blessed. They ain't know that I paid for my mama ticket married. She be happy for the rest of her life. That son I know, nigga. And last year I was broke, nigga. But they don't know.
Yeah.
What I've been through. They don't know that. They don't know. They don't know the hell. They only know what I tell them. They don't know that.
Yeah, you already know what the fuck going on, man.
In the post podcast.
Yeah, it's Saturday, motherfuckers.
We back.
Saturday, sir.
From a long, hard break.
Yeah, it's been one of them breaks, bro. Like, it's been crazy. It's been a long break and shit, though, for real. You've been gone for a few weeks now, like 3 weeks. Shout out to everybody who's still, you know what I'm saying, fucking with us and shit, still liking posts, you know what I'm saying, reposting, commenting, and all that good shit, man. We definitely appreciate all y'all and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, Pip just been saying, you know, it has been a long break, though. These past 3 weeks been longer than usual, you know what I'm saying? I know y'all see the T, maybe, you feel me? It may be y'all see the T and shit, you know what I'm saying? Rest in peace, Uncle Don and shit. Passed away a couple weeks ago, shit, they had to feel last week. You know what I'm saying? They wouldn't let me out the job, couldn't really make it and shit. But that being said, he was definitely a contributor and a supporter in the post, man, from the beginning. I'm talking about from the beginning, before they put all these flyers, motherfucking edits and all this shit on the shit, before we start really taking this shit to a level to where it's at today and shit. So, with that being said, we just gonna have a moment of silence for Uncle Don real quick before we get into this shit.
Before we get started with this, let me say, my Uncle Don was somebody who was real close to me. And we shared a birthday. And he was a twin. And he was my father's little brother, so it's a lot. It hit me from a lot to watch him. His brothers lose him, his twin lose him. And we share a birthday, so we... It took a whole lot out of me. And me and Pip done talked about this several times. The breaks are necessary. But it's about what you do when you come back from the break. You gotta have some type of progression, some type of movement, some type of generate something. And we try to generate positive shit for the city of Cleveland. So, hey, we on some new shit for Uncle Don. You know, he like to talk cash money shit when they pop up.
Yeah, so he nicknamed, you know what I'm saying? When I met this nigga, he talking about, you know what I'm saying? Damn, like, that's my homie Chase. He said, who you talking about, cash? That's cash. That nigga named Cash. Anytime I see him, he out here, cash money, that's cash, nigga. It's been like that ever since, though. Shout out to my boy, man. But so remember, we definitely talking cash money shit today.
Okay.
You feel me? Okay. NFL season is back in full effect. We had a game Thursday night. We had a game last night. So which game you want to start with first? You want to start with Thursday night, the kickoff game, Chiefs versus Ravens, or you want to start with the game last night in Brazil?
In Brazil,
the motherfucking, motherfucking Packers and Eagles, though.
Let's start with that because it was a lot of angry fans.
You said angry fans?
Yes.
And elaborate a little bit on that. Why was they angry?
You know, team, neither one of them get to see their team home opener. You know how that go?
I feel you.
Yeah.
I mean,
but it's a bigger picture. It's a lot. They trying to incorporate this football thing around the world. Now, all the sports that's above football, American football, are international.
It's soccer.
But the football is just us. We number three.
Yeah.
We hold number three, and it's just Americans, period.
That's.
So they trying to get on that soccer level. They're trying to get on that rugby type of
rugby vibe, so.
And the only way they can really get that is the people gotta see what we see when they watch.
Facts.
TV is different. A game, I done went to Browns games where the score was terrible. They didn't do nothing. The people they were playing didn't do nothing. But the actual watching of the game it's good. It was exciting because you get to see them try. Oh, they almost got it. Maybe they gonna get it next time. Maybe.
All right, so now that we got these little goofy-ass fans out the way, because y'all goofy as hell, y'all should be happy that your team is picked because they always pick the same teams year after year after year. All right, boom. Now to the game itself. It's week one. Y'all gonna hear me say this about this game, the game on Thursday. And I may be saying this next week when we get into the games that happen on Sunday and Monday. This is week one, and it's evident. Whatever the fuck is going on with these new rules, I may have to do some internet searching after this show today and try to figure out as far as the offensive line, as far as them getting onto the line, what is the specific notation in these bylaws to say where they supposed to be standing? Because I've been seeing those infractions way too much yesterday and Thursday. It's just way too much.
Illegal formation.
Yeah, it's just like, what the fuck? Like, I hate see that shit as much as I seen it in 2 days in my whole time of watching football. Like, see it, like, on a consistent basis. Like, we gonna get to that Ravens shit. Them niggas, the first two drives, they did that shit about 4 times. Like, what the fuck is going on? Now, to the games itself, though, the Packers are okay. Packers look decent. I'm gonna need to figure out who Jordan Love is, and hopefully that wasn't a bad ankle sprain. Hopefully he ain't out for too long, because it looked like it was a high ankle sprain. If that was the case, I don't know. I made that bet with Shaquille. I might be right about that. And I really was jumping out the window when I made that bet with Shaquille, because I forgot that Josh Jacobs is on the goddamn team. I forgot that Josh Jacobs was their running back. But they must have forgot, too, because they didn't get that nigga the ball at all yesterday. They must have forgot, too. Now, Jordan Love, he can throw that motherfucker. He can throw that bitch. Jay Reed, they got, you know what I'm saying, Christian Watson. The Packers going to be decent. We going to get into these divisions and shit? I don't know about their division right now, because there's a whole lot of fluky shit going on in their division, especially with the teams in the division. It could go one or two ways for all their teams. So we're going to get into this shit. But the Eagles, that's kind of how I thought that the Ravens was going to play Thursday. But I ain't really get that from the Ravens game. But I got that from that Eagles game, though. Saquon Barkley over there with the Eagles is going to be a problem. If he stays healthy, it's going to be a problem, nigga.
If he stay healthy.
Yeah, for sure.
And he got something to prove if he healthy.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
So, they needed a little more than the butt push?
Yeah, but they don't got that no more because Kelsey out of there.
Right.
And y'all got to figure that out, too. Way too many fumbles, bro. That's why I'm saying it's week one. Because if this is week five, I really think that the Packers blow out the Eagles. Just like I would say with the Ravens game, too. Like, niggas know I fuck with the Chiefs, but the Ravens is supposed to win Thursday. I don't give a fuck what you say. They ain't supposed to win Thursday, bro. They had that shit right on the platter. Just like the Packers had it on the platter to blow out the Eagles, because the center to quarterback pass off was off the entire game. They had three fumbles off that alone. They had three fumbles. The nigga threw an interception. So they had 4 turnovers and still won by 5.
That sounded like a blowout. That was
like, come on. I gotta give the Eagles defense credit. Because they held them niggas to motherfucking field goals. And it goes to what I said about Jordan Love. You're not Aaron Rodgers, bro. You're gonna have to be Jordan Love. You throwing all these back leg throws and shit. Every throw you throw is back leg. Like, switch that shit up, please, bro. Like, when you get back on the field, switch that shit up. You got your back. You not Aaron Rodgers, bro.
I mean, think about the Packers. They've been spoiled.
But that's the one thing I liked about Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers ain't come out there trying to be no motherfucking Brett Favre.
Yeah, he didn't.
That nigga Jordan Love out there trying to be Aaron Rodgers. Nigga, you not Aaron Rodgers, nigga. You begging for $50 million, you trying to be Aaron Rodgers. You not Aaron Rodgers, nigga. You ain't one shit.
Yeah, if you come out there and be Jordan
Love. Jordan Love, you like.
The Packers will set a quarterback up to be a good quarterback if you just be the best you. Be the best you.
Yeah, that's why I wasn't even a fan of him getting his money right then and there. You gotta give me 2 years of that for me to give you a bread. I wasn't really a fan of that.
I felt that he ain't did nothing.
He ain't did too much for that bread yet, but I'll give him credit. I mean, everybody gotta get their money. We're gonna talk about other niggas who need their money too. But that was a good game. Now, Thursday night. Nigga. I don't want to give up what I'm about to say when we get to this, when we get to that part of the show. But nigga, okay, they got a young fast nigga over there in Kansas City, that Xavier Worthy motherfucker. That motherfucker about he motherfucker Tyreek fast. He I don't know if he fast as Tyreek, but he fast. He at that level. He fast, bro.
He gonna take off on somebody.
Man, listen, bro. They gave him that ball on the motherfucking reverse. Boy, I swear to God, that looked like that boy took six steps. It was an end zone, man. Hey, bro. I'm telling you. I swear to God, that nigga took six steps, nigga. Six steps was an end zone, nigga. Pat Mahomes, still Pat Mahomes. You feel me? Travis Kelce, what the fuck is you got going on? I don't know what the fuck Travis Kelce got going on. And let's just go to a sidebar real quick. Travis Kelce, I don't know what the fuck you got going on. You feel me? That haircut look crazy. You got niggas in the streets talking about you signed a contract for a fucking relationship. And the contract up, y'all trying to renew the contract. Man, what the fuck is really going on, Travis? Like, what's going on? I know y'all done won back-to-back rings, bro. Don't start doing that Cleveland shit. Don't start doing that Cleveland shit, Travis. And I'm just leave it at that. Don't start doing that Cleveland shit. You know what these Cleveland niggas do? They up. They feel like they up. They get cocky. They start doing whatever the fuck. They start doing all type of stupid shit. Hey, Travis Kelce, please, bro. Do not do no Cleveland shit. I see it. I smell it on you, bro. You're about to start doing some Cleveland shit. I swear I feel it, bro. I just feel it. You see that nigga haircut, bro? You see how that nigga had it? That nigga... Man, that nigga look like Jason Kelce cut his hair, bro. Like, what the fuck is going on with this nigga, bro? But on to the game, though, I'm gonna be honest with you. The Ravens, man, I really want to see Lamar Jackson succeed. And I would love to see Lamar Jackson, in all honesty, beat a Patrick Mahomes and go to a Super Bowl. I feel like they got the pieces. They got the team. They got the receivers. You feel me? They defense. They got the pieces on defense. Nigga, as much as I was a Kansas City, niggas know I fuck with Pat Mahomes. I'm a Kansas City nigga when it comes to this football shit, even though I fuck with the Browns heavy and shit. Niggas know how I give it up when it comes to Pat Mahomes. Lamar Jackson did outplay Patrick Mahomes in stretches in Thursday night's game. It just was at the end of the game that just had me like, what the fuck? You see what I'm saying? The first pass to Likely, all right. You feel me? That was a little bit. He ain't have a lot of room and shit. That pass to Zay Flowers, nigga, that was the fucking game, bro. They was not on the same page. That shit flew right past Zay, and Zay like, damn. And Lamar like, damn, that was it. He wide open. Nobody's around this nigga. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Jim Harbaugh already talk about he go, they get first to go. He already put up the two signs already. The two signs up already before they even put the plays in. Ravens, man, they should have had that game. You know what I'm saying? They should have had that game. Pat Mahomes did Pat Mahomes things. That's cool. But they should have had that game. Lamar Jackson, bro. Come on, man. It's just week one. Okay? This is just week one.
So, it's looking like if your boy go back to the Super Bowl, if he not Bill Belichick,
you talking about Andy Reid?
Yeah.
Damn. I'm just thinking about that. Damn.
That's a legitimate argument now.
Cause shit, he went to one in Philly. They done went to three Super Bowls in Kansas City. And then you say if he go to one more.
And he win. He done, that man, he done three-peated.
Ain't nobody three-peated in a while, man. Ain't nobody three-peated. I don't know.
The last people to three-peat.
In any sport?
Yeah.
Shit. But as far as football, shit, I don't think that's ever happened, man.
I think the back-to-back might have been Dallas.
The back-to-back happened a lot of times. Like, Dallas went back-to-back. Patriots went back-to-back. A lot of niggas went back-to-back, bro. But a three-peat back-to-back-to-back, bro, I don't think that's ever happened in NFL history.
Yeah.
Who did it?
The Buffalo Bills.
They lost every time they went to the Super Bowl. I'm talking about they won three times in a row. Oh, man, that ain't happened, bro. Like, what? That ain't happened at all. But damn, though. I don't know, man. Like, we gonna get into this shit. We gonna get into this shit, but on some real shit. Last year was a year to get them niggas, man, to be honest with you. Like, last year was a year to get the Chiefs. Last year, the Chiefs, niggas ain't think they was gonna get make it to no fucking Super Bowl.
They did some Patriot shit.
But see, I feel you with that, but it's just like the climate of this.
How many Super Bowls did the Patriots look shitty as fuck on their way there?
Shit, yeah, 2019, they definitely did. But that's what I'm saying, though. I don't know, man. Like, that's a stretch right now. Like, I don't really, as much as niggas know I'm a real Kansas City nigga, I may even predict that shit at this point, but I'm not, I don't know. Am I 100%, like, 10 toes down into that shit? I'm going to have to see more games. It's just week one. And then on top of that, we ain't even seen none of the real games yet. But, this phone go Wi-Fi. You got a phone that don't, on you? Or the phone that don't need no Wi-Fi? Where that from?
This phone right here.
Let me see that phone. Let me see this phone real quick, man. God damn, let me see this phone. Hold on, I'll see what the fuck going on. He said Andy Reid, what? Oh, shit. I wanted to see for something. But I feel, you know, like, I don't know. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, the comparing coaches and eras, that shit is crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, but how many did Bill Belichick went to, like, 10, didn't he? Nah, yeah, he went about 10 of the bitches. 8, 9 of the bitches.
8. Oh, shit.
That nigga went to a lot of the bitches, man. You can't be putting that nigga in there with that nigga, bro. He went to a lot of the bitches, bro.
But three back-to-back.
But back-to-back is going to put him in a legendary category. I ain't going to lie to you. Because it ain't ever been done. Because it ain't never been done, though. All right, man. So we're going to dance with this bitch. All right. Now we about to get to these before the season, official season predictions. The season starts tomorrow. We're going to get into these before the season predictions. So this is what we're going to do, right? We're going to go division for division in the AFC, NFC. I'm going to ask Pimp with how many games he think is going to take to win the division. I'm going to, you know what I'm saying, concur or disagree, whatever the case may be. We're going to try to break down how the division is going to go in each one. Then once we do that, we could try to do some little pre-playoff early, like way too early playoff predictions from how the preseason and what niggas talk about in the whoop. And then we may get niggas an early Super Bowl prediction. Honestly, I don't know. I may cut that out because I don't know. We may do that. We may not. I don't know. But listen, boom. All right, we're going to start in the NFC on this one, right?
Okay.
NFC East. Eagles are already 1-0. Because they won Friday. So, Eagles, Cowboys, Giants, Commanders. Out of those four teams, who will be the worst team in the division?
The Commanders.
Huh? You think so? You think so?
No,
man?
Actually, I really say the fucking Cowboys, they going to fuck around. Probably do good and get bumped the first round.
They're gonna get like 10 like wins.
But I'm tired of that. I don't give a fuck how many. You can't keep just winning and fizzing out as soon as you get there.
So you say the Commanders is going to be the worst team in the division. I don't know. I like that little quarterback, the rookie quarterback, Jaden Daniels. I like him a little bit. He's a little bit better than Sam Howell. I just want to see how I look on the field. If I was had to pick, it would probably be the Giants. The Giants ain't getting 5 wins this year, bro. They get 5. The Giants ain't getting 5 wins. Flat out.
They gonna try to do something.
The Giants ain't getting 5. They gotta do something. The Giants, they don't got nobody. I like their receiver, my nigga Malik. I like Malik over there, but they ain't getting 5 wins. Maybe 6 to keep it lucky. The Commanders, on the other hand, they may win like 7 or 8 games. They may go 8 and 9. The Eagles, after how they look week one, I can see the Eagles winning 12 games. And to be honest, it's to be determined for the Cowboys. I already got to see the bum-ass niggas tomorrow against us. That's gonna show me everything I need to know about the Cowboys, bro. Because I hear the Browns are favorites in that game. I'm hearing niggas going for the Cowboys on the upset alert and all this goofy shit. So I got to see what's to it. But it's to be determined. Are they going to at least get 10 wins? The division winner of that is going to be the Eagles. The Eagles winning the division this year for the AFC East. Yeah. NFC East, I would say. All right, boom. NFC West. 49. Cardinals, Rams, 49ers, Seahawks. Out of those four teams, how many teams do you think can make the playoffs in the NFC West? From the Cardinals, the Rams, which is everybody's favorite team right now. Everybody hopping on the Rams. Rams, Rams, Rams. I'm like, I like Cooper Kupp. He healthy. I like the Puka Nua. But it's like, all right. You feel me? They don't got Aaron Donald no more. It's like, what you think? You know what I'm saying? Everybody know what the 49ers is. You see what I'm saying? So, what teams you think? And then the Seahawks, that's a sleeper, though. That's my sleeper, though. Seahawks, for real. Seahawks in the playoffs last year, wasn't it?
And I was thinking, too, possibly 3. I mean.
We got 2 more divisions to go, bro. Well, you say possibly 3. But, I mean, it's 7 teams that go, though. It's 7 teams that go.
The Rams might be in the 49ers. So with your team, the sleeper, it might be a 3, and depending on how the Cardinals come off. If they come off strong, they got every team come off strong at the beginning, you have a shot.
But they're a little more healthier than it was right. Last year. Kyler Murray back, and then you got my boy from Ohio State over there, Marvin Harrison Jr., and he may turn shit up.
So that's why it's a possibility 3.
Yeah. Okay, you say 3. All right, so when we say 3, I don't know. I'm going to say 2 for the time being. As far as who going to be the bottom of this division, I ain't going to hold you. It's going to be the Cardinals, but they're going to have 7 wins. Cardinals going to have 7 wins. I think the Seahawks can have anywhere from 8 to 9. The Rams, 9 to 10. And the 49ers, probably either 12-13. I'll
give them 11.
They'll probably win 13 games. If niggas healthy, it's over with. If C Mac and them niggas go down, it's over with. Straight up. All right, NFC North. And this is an interesting division right here. Bears, Lions, Vikings, Packers, and they just lost, so they're at the bottom of the division right now. So those four teams, out of those four teams, Pimp, which team is gonna be the most underachieving out of those four teams? The Bears, Lions, Vikings, and Packers.
I don't want to say this.
Be honest, though. We got to let this up and down.
The Lions.
Man. You say the Lions?
Yeah.
Woo!
Because if they don't come out smacking motherfuckers.
Woo, shit.
If they don't come out smacking motherfuckers, if they don't have a year like last year, motherfuckers is going to be upset.
But they had some injuries too. And for real, you know what? I would say the Bears, nigga.
Why would, I mean, you got a rookie. that jumped in the spot where it was already fucked up.
Man, they hyping that nigga to be Pat Mahomes 2.0. That nigga hyped up. Man, you got niggas talking about nigga going to the playoffs, nigga. No, bruh. Like, no, they talking about they winning 8-9 games. I'm seeing shit, they winning 10 games.
So they sound like they talking some Cleveland Brown shit.
But you got to think about it. You got Keenan Allen. You got DJ Moore. You got running back. You got a decent defense, too.
So, depending on what Love's situation is.
Yeah.
It's between them and the Lions. Who going to win that division?
To the Packers or the Lions?
Yeah.
I mean, I can concur with that.
So, at this point, if it's like it's between the Packers and them, you got Love who just dropped in a quarterback-friendly team. He a good quarterback. If you just let this bitch...
But if he out, though, I don't know about that. If he out for a long period of time, he out for like 6 weeks, I don't know about that.
So then that leaves the default to the Lions. That's just the Lions.
So this is the Lions division?
All right. So if the Lions don't take this, if the Packers don't, if Love ain't playing enough, the Lions need to be the surefire leader of that pack. And if they ain't, that'd be real disappointing.
All right, so here we go. So I'm going to break this down for y'all like this. At the bottom of this division, gonna be the Vikings. Y'all just don't got enough. Justin Jefferson, at this point, you got Jamar Chase out here sitting out talking about he want more money than you and shit. You ain't won no games since you been getting all this money. You was in the playoff party a few times. You ain't get no playoff berth wins, none of that shit. Because your team garbage. It ain't your fault. You need to get your ass up out of that. You need to get your ass somewhere where niggas out here trying to win, bro. You feel me? Because they wasting your talents over there. You like Randy Moss. You looking like Randy Moss. You see how they did Randy Moss. Randy Moss had to get the fuck up out of there. You feel me? So just word to the wise for you. Because you on that level. You on that Randy Moss level, my nigga. So y'all going to be at the bottom of the division. I say y'all win 6 games. Y'all win 6 games. Bears, y'all ain't winning no more than 8 games. Get the fuck out of here and talk about Caleb. Man, you got to show me. Right now, I'm going to say 8-9 for them. The Packers, depending on Jordan Love injury, if he out for 4 weeks, then they could get 10 wins. If he's out for more, then I must say around the same as the Bears. And the Lions are going to have 11 to 12 wins. You feel me? So if y'all listening to this shit on the playback and shit, we're going to break this shit down because he recorded. We're going to break this shit down, throw some clips up and shit. If I'm saying 11 to something, y'all go for the 11.5 on y'all betting, man. Y'all go for the 11.5. Y'all go hit every time. Trust and believe. Real rap. You feel me? We outside. All right. Last division. Really the worst division in the NFC to me. NFC South. Falcons, Panthers, Saints, Buccaneers. Out of those four teams, which team is going to be the most surprising team this season?
I ain't got a clue. I'm gonna be honest.
But this game shaking, making money down there in Tampa. You just got paid. That nigga shaking back just got paid.
Okay, I'm giving it a shaking back, man. What the fuck? I mean, for real. Outside of, ooh. When was the last time you watched any of them games, seriously? Any of them teams?
Shit, we had that bet last year. That was for like the last 4 weeks we had that bet last year. For like the last 4 weeks.
We be having to find a way to talk about motherfuckers.
Oh, shit.
Some of these things, we be having to find specific ways to even bring them up. Ooh, so we don't even see the bias. But for real, what was the last time? Other than the bet, have we ever discussed them teams?
Not really, though.
When Tom Brady went to Tampa.
Yeah, we did a little bit with Tom Brady. The most surprising team to me, I ain't going to fake. I'd probably go with the Buccaneers, too. but they're not going to win the division, though. I think the Falcons win the division easily. it ain't even gonna be a hard debate. They're gonna have like 10 wins, 11 wins. The Buccaneers gonna have 9 to 10 wins. The Saints, 7 to 8. And the Panthers, this give me 5, man.
It'll be 5 games?
Yeah, give me 5 this year, bro. I think y'all had, how many did y'all had last year? 1, 2? Give me 5, bro. This give me 5, man. I appreciate that. All right. AFC. Now, we're going to go for the bottom sometime. AFC. AFC South. Texans. Colts. Jaguars. Titans. Out of those 4 teams, which team you feel right now is head and shoulders in the driver's seat to win the division?
Texans.
And Dan, you didn't even think about that. Dan, you didn't even think about that, huh? I like the Texans too this year. I really do like the Texans though. I just.
So, your boy for the Jaguars?
I knock on wood. But they got to make it through the season though.
What's your boy? Your boy for the Jaguars? What he going to do?
Shit. What Justin Herbert been doing? The same shit? He Justin Herbert in that division, man. He got some numbers, but I don't know. I'm going to tell you like this though. The Texans should win the division. CJ Stroud, you know what I'm saying? Keep doing your thing. Stay away. Don't get to doing that dumb shit Jordan Love did yesterday, nigga. All them little back shoulder, back leg throws, nigga. Keep your feet in front of you, nigga. You, I don't need no ankle injuries. I don't need nothing from you. I need you to be healthy again. And we gonna see how this works. But I got y'all at the top of the division. Right under y'all, I got the Colts. For real. I think the Colts gonna have a better year than they did last year. The Colts won 9 games, and they had the same type of problems that the Browns had. They lost their starting quarterback, rookie quarterback that was being dynamic as hell. They lost that nigga like week 4. And they still was grinding. Still got Jonathan Taylor over there. Jonathan Taylor. I said the name right. You feel me? Like, the Colts is still high by regard. The Jaguars, y'all lost a lot of receivers, bro. Having the receivers y'all lost play for the Titans. How fucked up is that? Now, that's what's fucked up. And what's really fucked up is the Titans really trying to act like they gonna do something this year. It's crazy. Y'all ain't winning 6 games, nigga. Fuck out of here. Y'all did all that shit for what?
What?
They winning 6 games. Jaguars. This division gonna be tighter than niggas think. Cause I feel like that the Jaguars and the Colts are gonna have like 8 to 9 wins. Probably 10 between both of them. The Texans gonna have like 11. This is gonna be right there. All that shit gonna be tight. This is gonna be a tight division on the low. I'm telling y'all, between those 3 teams, I'm predicting a tight division. Pause. But 3 weeks from now, I could be looking like a dumbass because somebody could go 0-3. The motherfucking Jaguars got 0-3 written all over them, low key. But it is what it is. I'm gonna have faith. Trevor Lawrence. They call you the prince. That's promise or whatever. Come on, man. Come on, nigga. You was the number 1 pick. Turn your shit up, man. This year 4 for you, nigga. 5, 4, 5, 4. Come on, my nigga. Turn the shit up. All right, now boom. AFC North.
Let's go. We gonna do us
last. Oh, us last. All right,
do us last.
All right, AFC East. Bills, Dolphins, Patriots, Jets. Out of these 4 teams, shit. Out of those 4 teams, do you think 2 of those teams could have 10 plus wins this year?
Ooh. It's a possibility.
Yeah, which 2?
The Bills and the Dolphins.
Bills and the Dolphins?
It's possible.
But what about the Jets?
Who are their quarterback?
They know who their quarterback is, nigga.
He playing?
Yeah, nigga, he playing. Aaron Rodgers playing,
the whole
nigga.
Season.
don't know if he take that ass from God, whatever he be taking, he might. I don't know. But he playing, though. You don't think they're going to get 10 wins? 8, 9? The Jets? 8. I ain't going to hold you. I'm trolling. I'm here trolling like a motherfucker. Hey, no, but all whole time, though, I'm going to tell you this whole time. Just like I said about that, about the AFC South, I'm going to say the same thing about the AFC East. And moving forward, when it comes down to the AFC as a whole, pause, this season, whoever gets out the AFC winning the Super Bowl, nigga.
Yeah.
That's just bottom line. The NFC got some good teams. I like the Eagles, 49ers. But my nigga, the teams over here in the AFC are hands down better than anything over there in the NFC, bro. I'm here to tell you, nigga. So, boom. So with that being said, worst of the division, Patriots. Y'all not winning 3 games. Get the fuck out of here. Unless, and this is a big unless, though, pause. After 3 weeks, y'all start that rookie, Drake May. Y'all may win 6 games. I suggest y'all play Drake May sooner than later if y'all would have win more than 5 games this season, New England Patriots. And any of you niggas that's out there that got New England Patriots or your fantasy teams, you was auto-picking. I see niggas with Patriot players on their teams. They auto-pick it, bro. There's no fucking way. You should have anybody from the Patriots, no matter if it's a running back, wide receiver, tight end, defense, kicker. You should have nobody from the motherfucking Patriots or your team. I don't care how they look in college, nigga. You're going to lose, nigga. What is wrong with you niggas? I see niggas picking niggas for the Patriots. I said, my God, these niggas are crazy. I guess it don't matter if they win or lose shit. But I don't know if niggas gonna be getting the ball like that shit.
No, they're not.
I don't think them niggas gonna, you gotta run it back. I don't think that nigga getting 30 yards a game. Y'all niggas stupid as fuck. All right, man, so they the bottom. Under them. It's gonna be tough. But I'm about to be real. Jets, 7-8 wins. Dolphins, 9-10 wins. The Bills are gonna win the division. One thing that I do agree with, what I've been seeing from a lot of these pundits, Josh Allen can have an MVP season this year. Period. A lot of y'all think I be shitting on Josh Allen a lot. I really don't. I just say he can't beat Pat Mahomes. He'll never beat Pat Mahomes. That's all I say. I didn't say he was trash. I just said he ain't going to beat Patty. That's it. But as far as this season is concerned, as far as the Bills and what's going on in their division, the Bills should have 11 wins this year. They should win the division. Josh Allen will be in MVP conversations this year. I do believe in that because when it's all said and done, I think this year is going to be the year of like the top tier. I'm talking about like a quarterback that's ever been considered in the top tier. This is the year for them. I feel like Joe Burrow's going to have a great year. You feel me? We're going to get into that later on. But I feel like a lot of niggas are going to have great years. I feel like even when it comes down to it, Patrick Mahomes had a good game minus the interception Thursday. Lamar Jackson had a good game on the ground and throwing the ball as well. Jordan Love had a good game a little bit. He got injured in the end, but a little bit too many ill-advised throws. And the same with Jalen Hurts. They're not just garbage, though. Niggas not just garbage, so... I'm going to roll with the motherfucking Bills with the division and shit. All right. AFC West. Now the Chiefs are at the head of it because they won. So we got the Chiefs, Broncos, Raiders, Chargers. I'm going to ask you this on the AFC side, like I asked on the NFC side. Out of those four teams, which team is going to be the most surprising team out of the four? They're just going to come out of nowhere. You're like, damn, these things came out of nowhere and going crazy.
I mean, of course, the Chiefs going to do what they do. The Raiders are always giving it a try. Maybe the Broncos.
Damn, I ain't going to lie. I think the Broncos, too, for real. I don't know, man. I'm going to tell you this. I watch a little college football here and there. Bo Nix is a winner. He just got winner intangibles. Bo Nix. And I think the problem with Sean Payton, the reason why a lot of niggas was talking all that shit about Sean Payton last year, is because it's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. You see what I'm saying? You can't teach an old dog new tricks, nigga. Because if you try to do that, the dog is going to act like he already know what's going on. The dog going to ignore you. The dog going to go to the front office on you and shit. Sitting in his private quarters.
I'll take offense to that.
Hey, man, why? Because we're going to get into that nigga for real in a minute. Because, yeah, that nigga about to, hey. Yeah, nigga.
Hey, my nigga, you taught me some new tricks.
You ain't stuck in your ways, was you? Did you win before I taught you that shit?
I mean, yeah, I won before.
But what you mean? What we talk about as far as winning? So we talk about like winning like an equivalent of winning a championship. You've won that before? Or it's like, all right, I won some playoff games and shit. I'd have had some successful regular seasons. But as far as like that chip, like getting that ring, I ain't got that point yet. We ain't talking about, you know what I'm saying, you're better than, you feel what I'm just saying. But I'm just talking about, like, with personal goals and shit. Like, niggas that won some playoff games, but niggas ain't really won the ring yet.
Oh, no. I was a winner. I was a winner when you met me.
I mean, all right. Let me just put it like this. Let me try to come up with a better example for this. Like, Jordan came in the league and Jordan was a winner. But Jordan didn't win, like won the championship until he had the right pieces around him to win the championship. But he was still winning. He was a winner before that, though.
Yeah.
So we can concur that that's what's going on, right? Mm-hmm. With you. So what I'm saying as far as Sean Payton got a hold of a rookie who was shunned in Drew Brees and turned him into arguably one of the greater quarterbacks that ever played the game. He can't do that to Russell Wilson.
No.
You see what I'm saying? Okay. So it makes it look like he's a bad coach and Russell Wilson is a bad player because at the end of the day, they can't pull that off. What I'm saying?
They didn't meet in the middle ground.
Yeah, for sure. So I feel like with a quarterback, older quarterback, out of college, we still a little older, a little more mature. You feel me? Over 23, you like 24, 25. It could work. They still got some receivers over there. They got my nigga Surtain. They got a good defense over there. They ain't the most surprising team to be in this division. But even with that being said, the Raiders are at the bottom of the division. They winning 6 games. Under them, Chargers, I don't give a fuck about no Jim Harbaugh, nigga. You're winning 7 games, maybe 8 if you're lucky. Because Justin Herbert ain't healthy. You feel me? Boom. Then it's going Broncos? Dare I say maybe 9 games this year? If both niggas get to going, they can win 9 games? Maybe a wild card spot? Maybe. I'm not jumping out the window saying a wild card, but I'm telling you, they're going to be teetering ending the season 500. And that's a win. That's a win for them. And you already know the Chiefs will win 12 games, nigga. Or better, nigga. Fuck is you talking about? We back, nigga. We made 3-peat on that ass, man. Don't get it fucked up. Don't let Travis Kelce get his shit together. Don't let Travis Kelce pull up at that black barbershop next time with his hair grow back, nigga. Don't let that happen, nigga. It's over with. I'ma say it one more time since we talk about that shit. Hey, nigga, don't do that Cleveland shit, Travis Kelce. Hey, I see you already crazy. Don't shave half your head off, all that crazy shit. Hey, man, chill out. Oates, man, that's your nigga. He from the Heights. Get your nigga, bro. That's your nigga, bro. Tell that nigga chill, bro. We trying to get to we trying to do some shit that ain't never been done, nigga.
You know how Cleveland kids. You know how
we trying to do some shit that's never been done.
You know how Cleveland people get.
Yeah, they get crazy. Once
they get out, they get all out the pocket.
Shit, what's good? Got me shredder. This bitch was good. Hold on, what this nigga say? I can't see what this nigga said. I don't know what he just said. I don't know. My bad. We on this shit on the joint. But I'm all right. Since he said wait till last, we here.
Okay, now I'm gonna say this. He said whoever come out of our division is gonna win. Not our division, our the AFC.
That's what you just said?
Yeah. No, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, I already just said that.
You just said that. Now, first of all, all the people in them other divisions all got to play our division. And our division is flat out going to be a gauntlet. If Joe Burrow is decent, if he healthy, they do a little something for that line, offensive line. They got a shot to do some shit. The Browns, of course, we probably the people watching the most. They gonna pay the most attention to. Mm-hmm. Of course, we know what the fuck the Ravens gonna do. Mm-hmm. And you can't not pay attention to the Steelers because somehow.
Man, listen, man. Yes, I can, man. Yes, man, I will. Somehow, and I will. And I will this year. And I fucking will.
How?
And I motherfucking will, how? Man. Matter of fact, you know what? Let's just get straight into it, man. The Steelers going to be the worst team in the division. The Steelers ain't winning 500. The Steelers going to win 7 games, maybe 6, nigga. Got me fucked up. So, I'm sick of this shit. I'm sick of you niggas, bro. You niggas keep going on nostalgia. Fuck them niggas. They been trash for 3 years, man. Get the Steelers the fuck out of here. Now this nigga Russell Wilson got a last-minute injury. He not playing tomorrow. What you think Justin Fields going to do? Justin Fields is about to be throwing picks. He about to throw a picket house, a picket fence in this motherfucker. Man, get them niggas out of here, bro. Fuck is you talking about? I don't care about that shit. We is gonna be a gauntlet for sure because it's 3 teams. It's the Ravens, it's the Bengals, and it's the Browns, nigga. Cause y'all niggas sleeping on Deshaun Watson. Y'all been sleeping on that nigga. Y'all been hating on that nigga, mad he getting this money. Talk about let that nigga go. Joe Flacco, Flack attack, all this goofy shit y'all niggas been talking about for the past 2 years. That shit ends Sunday, nigga. It's over. That shit ends Sunday, nigga. I'm sick of this shit. Y'all niggas been playing my nigga. He just wanted to look. Nigga, the Houston nigga said it was cool for the bitches to rub on that nigga, bro. Fucking, then they gonna roll out. Then they gonna fucking railroad the nigga when they traded away all his pieces and thought that nigga was just gonna play. No, trade me too. You gonna get D-Hop up out of here in his prime, nigga? Trade me too, nigga. Fuck is wrong with y'all niggas? Y'all hating on Deshaun getting all that bread. Even though I know it is a crazy trickle effect because I don't think Jordan Love will be getting that bread and butter for Deshaun Watson. But whatever, fuck it. This is the year of redemption, nigga. Deshaun Watson coming for anything that y'all niggas tried to take from that nigga. And while he come back, y'all taking the shit on the low. I heard from a birdie told me that lefty's cheesesteak up there off motherfucking South Taylor is a motherfucking hit. I gotta see what's to that shit. Niggas say it's a hit. That's what the streets saying. The streets saying that shit is a hit. The seasoning on point. They got the curly fries in that bitch on point. They might do the burgers for you. I'm telling you, they say the bitch is on point up there. Across the street from the motherfucking haunted house, little cat, what you feel me? The little haunted house restaurant, nigga, on South Taylor, nigga. I'm going to have to pull up on that nigga, man. I'm going to have to see what's to it. I'm going to have to see what's to a lefty motherfucking cheesesteak, because the left-hand nigga number four is about to turn up for show, nigga. I'm tired of that shit. I'm tired of you niggas, bro. We got receivers. We got motherfucking Coop, nigga. We got Amari Coop. We got my nigga Jerry Judy out there, nigga. We got Njoku, nigga. Nick Chubb be back by week five. Don't worry about it, nigga. We still got one of the best offensive lines in the game, nigga. And the defense ain't no hoe. Myles Garrett is putting that nigga Dak to the flow three or more times tomorrow, though. Fuck is y'all talking about, man? It's time, nigga. We in this bitch, nigga. Dog pound, nigga. I ain't about to start doing that yet, nigga. I'm gonna hold that shit to tomorrow, nigga. But you know what's up. So, like I'm saying, nigga, AFC North, nigga. Bengals, Browns, Steelers, Ravens. Out of those four teams, who gonna be better than the Browns, though? Out of those four teams, which teams is gonna have a better record than the Browns in the division, nigga?
I can only honestly say maybe the Ravens.
Maybe the Ravens?
Maybe.
Maybe you do that. I just ain't like how they was using motherfucking Derrick Henry that first game. I ain't like that. I mean, really, I made me fear him. It's really just like they're the same team. Like, you just got a name. Like, they're the same team, y'all. The only motherfucker who's gonna run is Lamar Jackson. If that's the case, okay. I got something for that. If Lamar Jackson gonna be the only nigga running. You feel me? I thought they was gonna do Derrick Henry like they did, you know, say Saquon. Saquon running that motherfucker. Derrick Henry ain't really doing as much. So we gonna see. That shit ain't as scary. That shit, after the first game, it's still week one. That shit ain't looking scary as I thought it was gonna be. When they first got that nigga, I thought that shit was gonna be scary. Lights out. You feel me? It don't look as scary as I thought.
I mean, but.
It just don't look as scary as I thought, bro. I ain't worried about the niggas like that.
They was trying to throw together some schemes they already had. They didn't have to rely on that problem. Then they gonna work him into that.
Mm. All right.
I mean, that's what I would do.
Now, like I said,
if you can't stop the one trick, I'm gonna do the one trick until you decide to think you gonna stop it. And I'm gonna,
I ain't gonna favor that nigga. But that nigga, man. That nigga, Lamar Jackson, fast motherfucker, though.
Yeah.
But as far as the AFC North, and this is the last thing we're going to do, then we're going to get into some other shit, because I was going to say who was going to the playoffs and early Super Bowl predictions, but hey, fuck all that, nigga. We ain't never did that, and we ain't doing that shit today. But as far as these predictions for these wins, I got that all day for you niggas. Now, y'all can go back to the whole show, Ocean, go watch the whole show. I broke down the whole NFL, AFC, NFC on the wins and everything. Now, when it comes to the AFC North, nigga, I'm going to say it one more time for you niggas. You Steeler fans are in for a long year, nigga. It's about to be a long year for you niggas. I've been waiting, patiently waiting for this shit for a long time now. Y'all niggas been above 500 for damn near half of my life, nigga. That shit be irritating me. Y'all team's trash, losing the playoffs, but y'all still want more games than us. So y'all can talk shit to us. But it is this year. It's over this year, nigga. It's over this year, nigga. We had more wins than last year. This is going to be back-to-back, nigga. And y'all snuck in the playoffs because of the punk-ass motherfucking Jacksonville Jaguars. I'll never forgive y'all for that. I'll never forgive you whole-ass niggas. Trevor Lawrence, you lucky I still won that motherfucking fantasy, your bitch ass. You lucky I still won that money, nigga. You lucky, nigga, because if I would have lost that money, nigga, I swear to God, I'd have pulled up to Jacksonville. You had to get a little Duval to get me up off your stupid ass, nigga. Like, what the fuck? But yeah, man. Steelers winning 6-7 games this year. Six and seven games for the Steelers.
I'm trying to get us in this Steelers bar. The Steelers backer bar.
I mean, we can get in there, man. Hey, I ain't going to talk. Hey, listen, bro. We going to get up in there. Hey, listen, bro. But you know, I'm gonna be cool. I'm gonna talk that shit to y'all. I'm just playing like nigga, they didn't beat. I ain't saying fuck your mama and shit. Niggas ain't saying that. Niggas just saying your team garbage. That don't mean, like, what the fuck do that mean? I can pour a shot with a nigga that say, man, LeBron trash as fuck. I can still pour that nigga a shot. Like, I'm not mad at that nigga. fuck is you mad? Like, what you mean? Like, I'm about to be mad at a nigga because he's talking down on the nigga I fuck with on the basketball side. I can see if a nigga was talking about I beat Oates' ass in the spot. Oh, yeah, we gonna dog the fuck out your stupid ass. But, oh, fuck LeBron. He a bitch. I'm supposed to swing on you, nigga. Get the fuck on out of here, man. Like, the Steelers is the worst team in football. You gonna beat my ass, nigga? That's what you owe? All right, say less, nigga. You a bitch ass, nigga. Nah, I swear. You better keep them niggas away from me that's gonna do that. Them niggas hoes. Hey, nigga, hoe like a motherfucker. You gonna pull up on me, gonna get mad at me because I said his team trash. Like, nigga, what? Niggas ain't saying shit to you, ain't did shit to you. But your team trash, you wanna work. You wanna turn up. Or you go home. Like, come on, man. Y'all niggas, man, it's 2024, man. Y'all gotta tighten the fuck up, man. Like, I don't know what the fuck be going on with these niggas, man. Like, niggas be really tweaking. Hey, niggas be really tweaking.
What it is now, these niggas, they parlays be fucked up now.
Oh, yeah. If the parlay fucked up, I feel you. If a nigga get loud like that, I say, oh, you put a bet in? You say, hell yeah, nigga. I say, you know what? You want a shot or something, man? Let me get you a beer or something, nigga. You need to take a load on this shit.
These parlays got niggas hating their favorite team.
But then they got me fucked up. I can't even put it in there. All right, boom. Steelers draw 6-7 wins. Bagels. Y'all 9-8-9. That Jamar Chase shit. I don't know if it's gonna bite y'all in the ass. Pause. But the thing that will is that I don't really trust y'all running game. And I don't trust that offensive line still of the Bengals. I don't trust it.
Don't trust it.
You know what I'm saying? If Joe Burrow is healthy, then it's like the Josh Allen effect. Oh, this is the same thing to me. You feel me? I feel like Joe Burrow being healthy elevates the Bengals. If Joe Burrow healthy for real, I'm going to be honest, they win it like 9 to 10 games for real. It's going to be 3 teams in this division that's going to have at least 10 wins. 9 to 10 wins. It's going to be 3 teams in this division that's going to have 9 to 10 wins, just like last year if you look at it. Yeah. The Steelers fucked around and got 10 wins last year. Steelers, Browns, Ravens. This year I think it's going to be Ravens, Browns, Bengals. Let's go have 10 wins. That's just a fact, nigga. This is a tough division for sure. But at the end of the day, niggas got to beat the Kryptonite. And that goes for any team in this AFC that we just broke down. If y'all could beat that Kryptonite that's over there in Kansas City, y'all could win that Super Bowl. For real. But y'all gonna have to beat that. Y'all gonna have to beat that curly hair, nigga. Y'all gonna have to outdo my old school white dude that love cheeseburgers. You gonna have to outdo them niggas. If y'all wanna get to that Super Bowl, and that's just what it is.
Listen here. They going to the Super Bowl. Whoever knocked our division off. Whoever
about nigga wins. Trap.
That's our shit. Whoever wins. It's so much. Whoever come out of our division gonna be battle tested.
But at the end of the day, I'll tell you this. The last team that got out of our division, which is the Super Bowl, was with the Bengals in 2021. Mm-hmm. They lost. Ravens keep losing to the motherfucking Chiefs. And what was that? The year where the Chiefs won the Super Bowl. No, the year where the Chiefs lost to Tampa Bay, if I'm not mistaken. We lost to the Chiefs when Miles Garrett and them niggas got that nigga, took that nigga Pat Mahomes out, and the backup nigga beat us.
Shit on us.
The backup nigga dogged our shit. So, I'm just saying, like, Pat Mahomes,
was,
like, them niggas is... them niggas
was
is
the Lions, wasn't we?
I can't remember where the fuck niggas was at. Niggas smoke a lot of weed, bro. I can't remember where niggas was at. But I just know that happened. I don't know where I was at. I don't know if I was at my dad's house or watched that. I don't know where the fuck I was at. I could have been a lot of places, bro. Like, niggas was moving at that time, 2020. I was out here. Everybody. I could have been at Big T in the house. They still alive there.
Yeah.
For real. Niggas are still rocking. Niggas are still alive. Niggas still popping. So, we gonna see. Now, let's slide into this shit, because I do want to talk about this shit, because I got another little rat in me. Like I said, I'm talking cash with this shit today. Anthony Edwards. Now, we've been gone for a minute, man. And I'm going to be honest. The only reason why we're talking about this shit now is because I couldn't find a good post to screenshot so I could put my face in the corner and go the fuck off for a minute, 30 seconds. If I would have did that during our break, I probably would have said shit about this shit. It's a couple of things that... It's one more thing I do want to talk about that I couldn't find a good meme to discuss where I want to go to, too, as well. We're going to get into that shit after this. But Anthony Edwards saying that the only skilled player in the 90s was Michael Jordan. When I initially heard this, I said, man, these young niggas taking this trolling shit to another level. Because there's no fucking way. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I understand niggas is young, and he's a younger player. But there's no fucking way he can make that statement and mean it. And then back it up by saying the only reason why niggas was going crazy for Kobe was because Jordan was the only skilled player in the league. And that's what had me like, what? That shit had me flabbergasted, bro. I was fucking flabbergasted. I was like, is this young nigga crazy? Like, all right, I was giving a piece. You feel me? I had a whole argument with DJ last show and shit. I was giving a piece and shit. He ain't wood shit. Ooh, I'm just like, damn, but the young nigga doing this thing, he balling. You feel me? And then he said that shit, Team USA, talking about I should be the number one option. I'm just like, I feel him. That's moxie. I get that. But now?
Clickbait.
Yeah, man, this nigga tweaking.
Clickbait.
Hey, man, listen, man, I understand, bro. You had a long season this year after the year. It was probably the longest season you'd have had in a minute, even with COVID. Then you played a regular season. You played deep into the playoffs pause. Then you went to the Olympics. Hey, man, I suggest you just fall the fuck back. Fall the fuck back. I shouldn't hear or see a thing about Anthony Edwards until the end of September.
See?
Like, just fall the fuck back.
I understand why they might feel like that. Think about how many people didn't get on during the Michael era.
I mean, but didn't get on is one thing, nigga. This is what I'm saying. Where did Kyrie Irving get that shit from?
Shit, the handles?
Yeah. Who had handles similar to that in the 80s and 90s? Niggas that Jordan played against. I don't know, Rod Strickland, his fucking godfather, nigga?
Yeah. Allen Iverson.
Nigga, you got, but Allen Iverson is in 2008. That ain't what I'm talking about. Sharif Abdul-Rahim, what skilled, nigga? That's what we doing? So Clyde Drexler was skilled either. Magic. I know Magic replied, but I mean, it is what it is. I'll reply to niggas. Yeah, like what? Like what is we talking, Dominique Wilkins? What is we talking about here, bruh? Like, what is we really talking about? Like, that's what I'm saying. When I hear this, I'm just like, my nigga, just fall back somewhere. Get a bitch or something. Fuck a bitch or something. Stop talking to these niggas. Just stop talking to these niggas. That's what all y'all should do sometimes. Like, nigga, cut your phone off. Stop talking to these niggas all the time, bro. Niggas get to say stupid shit just because you talking this shit. You trying to get your mind off. You trying to get a bar. And niggas want to take advantage of that shit, man. Hey, man. Shut the fuck up sometimes. Chill. Hey, that was unnecessary.
This is what really happens. This is what we do. I know how to get my man gassed up and say some shit to have him going. But he is fully aware of what we doing because this shit recording.
But I'm saying educated shit no matter what is it. If it's hype or calm down, I'm saying educated shit from an educated place. I'm thinking about what I'm saying. That shit is illogical for him to even utter that out of his mouth, and he means it though. And a young nigga meant it though. That's the shit that's that's really like, ugh. You better go off next year, nigga, because to be honest, the last nigga who did some shit like that, who was talking shit like that after winning MVPs, was Russell Westbrook. See what happened to that nigga. He about to be a good role player now. Okay. That's what happens to niggas. And it's early in his career, so I don't want to put that on him. You feel me? But I just feel like at the end of the day, it's just like, this is unnecessary, man. You got to chill. That's clickbait. That nigga's trolling.
Trolling.
Yeah, niggas trolling, man. Trolling. Like, niggas got to chill, man. Because what happens is you niggas trolling, and then they talk about your trolling ass for 2 weeks. You got everybody talking about your trolling ass. These niggas is dumber than you because they think you real. They think you telling the truth. These niggas dumber than you. Some of these niggas on TV dumber than you. Now to the last thing I want to discuss today before we go in the building for a little minute, be about this bitch. This whole Caitlin Clark shit, WNBA shit. Caitlin Clark's having a great year. Caitlin Clark turned up after that Olympic break. She turned the fuck up. I gotta give her credit. Rookie of the year, hands down. Anything else will be uncivilized. MVP going to Asia Wilson. But I'm telling you this right now, and this is what the truth is. Caitlin Clark is going to end up getting into that playoffs and is going to start doing some crazy shit. While Asia Reese is going to be at home during these playoffs. Just let that sink in. Angel Reese, I don't give a fuck. I don't know why niggas is still, whoever the fuck is mad at Angel Reese for this Caitlin Clark shit, either just throw it away, give it up. That's been 3 years ago. They was in college 2 years ago. Let that shit go, nigga. That shit ain't about right now. Your girl is winning. Caitlin Clark is winning. Her team is one game over 500. Reese's team is 10 games under 500. And they're fighting for the last playoff spot with another team that's 10 games under 500. Everybody else is in the playoff realm is anywhere from 3 to 5 games over 500. So let that sink in again for you niggas. You niggas, if you niggas want to motherfucking critique this shit like the men, then do that. But don't be giving niggas passes. Don't give these hoes no passes. No disrespect. Don't give these ladies no passes, though, I'm going to say. You feel what I'm saying? If she playing like trash, she playing like trash. Angel Reese, she got more offensive rebounds than defensive rebounds. Why is that?
Tristan Thompson.
Shit. Tristan Thompson ain't missing much as she do. She be missing. Hey. But what you about to say, Pip?
Now, I told you that it's a possibility that both of them will make it on the playoff spot.
I mean, it is a possibility, but I ain't know that they both not did the one that one team was going to be shining and rising and the other team was going to be god-awful. I don't want nobody being no playoffs 10 games out of 500 in any motherfucking sport. What the fuck? Any fucking sport. Niggas get motherfucking praise for having 10 and 11 over and over and over. Y'all get beat by 20 and you praising the bitch for getting 10 and 11. No, disrespect. No, you praising her for getting 10 and 11. Like, man. Like, whatever. So then when you talk about that, oh, you're hating on your black women. You're hating on, man, my goodness. She not balling. Like, whatever. Whatever. Shout out to Angel Reese, man. Shout out to Kevin Clark. Man. You got anything else to say about this shit? Because shit, I don't know. I don't know, nigga. Like I said, I don't talk a lot of cash money shit today. Nigga. I'm about to die. Nigga. I think we might. You feel me? I'm going to let my nigga get this shit off. I think we might be a pop.
All I got to say is every great player don't necessarily have to be an offensive player.
I mean, true indeed. But I just feel like that the Scott team ain't as good. They're 10 games under 500. The team not good. That's not dog and Angel Reese, but they not good.
I mean, but if she scored some of them points, if she scored half of them points, she missed.
Yeah,
it
still
might have been a different story.
I mean, but she not that type of player. She got to get more post moves. She'll gain that over time. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, she's good for where she's at right now. Caitlin Clark is good for where she's at right now. Is Caitlin Clark a top 10 player in the WNBA? Fuck no.
No.
But, I mean, she's dynamic, though. Like, at the end of the day, I'll tell you this. And before we get up out of here, Tyrese Halliburton to me is not a top 10 player in the league. But he's, you feel me?
He
working at that shit.
He trying.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He working at that shit. I give him that. That's what I'm saying about Caitlin Clark. But you already know what the fuck going on, man. We done had a nice little show of shit, man. Next week, we're going to be at the Smoker Divas Lounge and shit. He gonna post the
flyers.
Yeah, he gonna post the flyers and stuff at the beginning of the week for that this Saturday. Next Saturday. So hopefully, if y'all in the area, y'all got nothing to do, y'all can pull up on us at Smoking Divas Lounge. We're gonna have a few guests up there with us as well and shit. So y'all should just pull up. We're gonna let y'all know more about that beginning of the week on Monday and shit. my pimp got the little, you know what I'm saying, the camera shit working. So,
chop, chop.
That should be working too. So be on the lookout for that. And it will be on YouTube too, too. We back on YouTube as well. Tuesday, Wednesday. Shit back on YouTube. In the post, podcast on everything. I mean, every single thing. You feel me?
Oh, so while we on here, not this Tuesday, but next Tuesday, after all the first round of everything broke down, we gonna hop back on this Tuesday night quarterback?
I'm gonna be honest with you, nigga. We probably start Tuesday night quarterback after our event, the end of the year. Or end of the month, I'm going to say.
After
our event, the end of the month, that first week of October after the, you know what I'm saying, tailgate situation, end of the month, we coming back with that Tuesday night quarterback. But right now, we out here. We got some shit in the works within these next few weeks. So we just go handle the shit we got in the works and shit. You know what I'm saying? Got some guests coming through. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be out popping. We're going to be out popping our shit. We're going to be in a few events and shit, few situations.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we out here, nigga. So y'all gonna see what's up. Y'all gonna see what's up. You know what I'm saying? We back now. So it is what it is. We back now, nigga.
Let me tell them a little bit about the fourth annual Diva giveaway. They giving back to the community. They got meals. They gonna give away. They gonna have a bounce house and vendors. You know what I'm saying? So it's family friendly for all ages. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be us in the building with the lovely Divas. Plus, we're going to have a couple guests come through.
Oh, yeah, we're going to have some guests come through. Y'all should come through, too, because it's a, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, y'all should come through, nigga. Like I said, nigga, Blood and Brunch on the 22nd of September. Blood and Brunch. Shout out Miss Pooh 2 times. My nigga going to chop this shit up. Shout out to her. She will be in the building for that. We will try to, you know what I'm saying, shoot some little footage. She going to chop up. Ooh, there's going to be a little video, a little recap type shit. You see what's going on. You know the vibes, nigga. So y'all should pull up to Smoking Divas next week. She going to be in the building. Get you a ticket or something. She may have some of them edibles on her too, low keezy. Fuck with us, nigga. It's legal now, nigga. Fuck with us, nigga.
So.
What?
I mean, it's, we up. That's all.
Nigga, we on 10, motherfucker. Yeah. What?
Yeah.
You know what's going on, nigga. In the meantime, in between time, nigga, I get with you, nigga.
We ain't got no outro.
Man, we just cut this shit off, man.
Hold up. Show my man on top of you. Yeah. Yeah, man. Shout out to Stick Stitcher, too. Tees is still available, nigga. All type of tees is still available. Shout out to Stick Stitcher, nigga. Feel me? Straight like that, bro. For sure.